To start a new application, you need to click on New Application. In the drop-down list, you choose the crop and one of the available authorities. In this case, we'll choose Soybean and Kenya as the selected authority. The Kenyan authorities do not require a breeder's reference. However, the PBR application tool needs information to identify the variety, and therefore the system makes the breeder's reference mandatory. This is the submitter's own reference. In this case, we will use DemoRef as an example. The application must be completed in a language accepted by the selected authority. We also need to select the language for answers if the authority accepts applications in more than one language. For Kenya, for example, only English is available. Whereas in Canada, French and English are accepted and so are available in the list. So let's start. The forms are generated automatically based on the information provided by the authority. Only the chapters that are required by the authority are displayed. All the questions are organized by subject and separated into three main groups: application form, technical questionnaire, and declaration and signature. For Kenya, under application form, we need to complete information on applicant, breeder, denomination, other applications, priority claim, and novelty information. Under technical questionnaire, we need to complete information about the breeding scheme, variety characteristics, variety comparison, plant material information, and additional information. The final set of questions is related to the declaration and signature and attachments. Let's start from the beginning at the application form chapters. In the applicants chapter, all the information is taken from the applicant profile, as you can see on the screen. For breeder, let's select the country where the variety was bred, Australia. I will complete only the information about this breeder. For the denomination, we will add demo. At the other applications chapter, we can select where a previous application was made and then insert the variety name. In this example, DemoRef. In this example, I will not claim any priority under the priority claim chapter. So for novelty, I select Australia as the country of sale. I need to insert the date of first sale or offer for sale, and then add terms or conditions of sale. Once all the mandatory fields of the application form chapters have been completed, each chapter will be indicated as complete, and you can see this in that the red exclamation sign has changed to a green tick. The technical questionnaire group then needs to be completed. For breeding scheme chapter, I can, for example, say that my variety results from crossing and click on controlled cross. I then have to complete male and female parents. Then I complete the method of propagating the variety. In the Variety Characteristics chapter, you can choose one of the proposed states of expression for each characteristic. In the Variety Comparison chapter, I can choose one or multiple varieties which are the most similar. The drop-down list displays all available characteristics. If I choose one, the corresponding states of expression will be displayed automatically. I can then select one of those to make sure that we can compare the variety. The next chapter is about plant material information. I will complete the information here on resistance to pests and diseases, special conditions for examination of the variety, and other information. as the field should be completed according to the information required by the selected authority. The final chapter is about additional information. Again, once all mandatory fields of these chapters have been completed, they will be indicated as complete with a green tick. To complete the declaration and signature chapter, I need to browse and upload my signature into the application. At the attachments fields will differ for each authority depending on their particular requirements. In this case, the authorization for release is required. Once all the chapters have been completed, you can either save or submit directly the information. All the mandatory fields are completed. You can see that all have a green tick, and that's why you are now able to submit. In the submission process, you will need to accept the PBR application tool disclaimer. Sometimes there is also a PVP office disclaimer, which also needs to be accepted. But for this case, only the PBR application tool disclaimer is required. Now the application data has been submitted. It is not required to pay at this stage. My account is linked to my email address. You can see here that my application has been sent to Kenya, with a copy to me because I'm the applicant. In the body of the email, you will get all the information about the international reference number, which was assigned to the application. Proposed denomination, date of submission, and a link to download the application data in a secure way. To guarantee data confidentiality, only you, as the applicant, and the PVP office are allowed to download this application data. When I click on this link, as I'm already logged in, I'm authorized to see this information. I can save the zip file. You can see the application data in PDF format, with all the information I've already inserted. It contains the breeding scheme, the variety comparison, variety characteristics, and so on. In the zip file, you can get the XML documents, application form and technical questionnaire. The information is secured in the XML format so that it can be used by other systems. Now I have submitted my application data to Kenya. In the dashboard, I can see all my applications. I can search for submitter's own reference, which contains the term demo ref. I can see that my application is submitted. The payment status is pending applicant's payment because I didn't pay.